All glory and honor be to the blessed name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today's meditation is titled as A Consistent Prayer of Faith, and scripture is taken from the Gospel according to St. Luke chapter 1 verse 24 and 25. It reads, "After this, his wife Elizabeth conceived, and for 5 months she remained under seclusion. She said, 'This is what the Lord has done for me and took away the disgrace I have endured among my people.'" Dear sisters in Christ, Elizabeth and Zechariah were a devout family. Both were righteous before God and lived a blameless life as they diligently followed all the commandments and regulations of Jewish priestly tradition. Still, they had a void in their life. They had no children. As women, we all understand the joy of giving life to a new being and to be a mother. Elizabeth was not such a one. She was yet yearning in her old age to have her own child. Every moment of her life must have been spent in persistent prayer for a child. Barrenness was considered to be a curse. Elizabeth, being from a priestly family, must have found it difficult to cope with the societal outlook and with the perspectives about barren women. Thus, she must have gone through humiliating experiences in life which added to her sorrow. But her only hope and strength was prayer, a persistent prayer. Elizabeth's priestly background would have instilled hope in the Lord and determination to hold on to her faith. Such a faith continued to grow stronger every passing day to become a strong faith. That brought her patiently to the result she always wanted. So is it said in Luke chapter 1 verse 13, "Your prayers have been answered." Her cries, unseen, unheard, and desires of heart were continually in the presence of God. Another limitation of her life was physical weakness, as her husband and Elizabeth were very old by age. But as the word of God says, nothing is impossible by God. Her weakness becomes her strength to glorify God. God works beyond human reasoning and knowledge. As said rightly in the prophetical book of Isaiah, "Our ways are not his ways, neither our thoughts his thoughts." God intervened in Elizabeth's life in such a way that her limitations became testimonials about God's marvelous deeds in life. God's favor came upon her in God's own time. Verse 25 says, "He looked favorably on me and took away the disgrace that I have endured among my people." The favor of God rested on her in such a way that her physical weakness became ways for divine provisions. It put to rest all human reasoning and ability and let only God's wisdom to prevail. The favor of God prepared Elizabeth physically and spiritually to receive the blessing of God that God has promised solely for them, that is, John the Baptist. She was filled with Holy Spirit and was strengthened in her body to carry the one who prepared the way for the Lord. Her life became a witness of God's favor not only in her family but also among her people and society. Remember, dear sisters, personal pains she suffered were treasured and not wasted in God's register. Today, we too encounter many life situations where our limitations and weakness appears much more prominent than God's promises and provisions. Our resources seem scarce and short of a need. The secret to change such a situation is to seek God's grace over it. Let us not be very careless with His grace and be alert to use it purposefully for the glory of God. Let's not take God's grace for granted. Often, we become barriers for God's interventions in our life by our own thoughts and reasoning. Let us draw strength from His unlimited source of grace to pray fervently and to trust Him completely with all our heart. Let our responses to problems be controlled by our prayers and with hope, as nothing is impossible for God. But we must work to nurture a heart of faith, hope, and determination as we pray. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your ways and your provisions in our life. Lord, lead us to a life beyond our limitations and helplessness. Help us to be a testimony for you, however we are. We pray for your grace and mercy to rest upon our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.